princes, dignitaries, delighted to be part of this inauguration today of the second Yoga and Ayurveda conference here in this really beautiful hall, this new hall in this beautiful palace of Saraswati. This is a very special creation by Mr. and Mrs. Barr, and I commend the effort that you have made, the passion with which you have created this beautiful space and also the beautiful concept of the study, the modern study of yoga and Ayurveda. And I commend, of course, my senior and predecessor ambassador in Poland, Ambassador Bhandari, for being part of this wonderful idea and for taking it forward in such a scientific, in such an organized way. In many ways, what you're doing is wonderful at several levels, because yoga is, after all, an ancient technology. It's a gift of India to the world. It's 5,000 years old, if you count it from the Indus Valley civilization, or 2,005 years old, if you count it from Patanjali's Yoga Sutras. But whatever its vintage, this is an ancient technology, and it's wonderful that the Apollo Institute of Technology is updating it, it's evaluating it in a modern scientific way, and it's an absolute delight for us that there is actually going to be a postgraduate course studying this subject and spreading the message of yoga. In many ways, what you're doing is a pioneering effort, but you are also part of a global connection. You know, in India, we have a huge ambition of taking our country forward, modernizing it, and growing it at a rate of more than 10%. It's already the fastest growing large economy in the world. But as Ambassador Bhandari said, we need the balance. We need to balance the material with the metaphysical. So while growing at this very fast rate in India, we also want the gift of yoga to go to the world, because that is, after all, a gift of bliss, a gift of well-being, of balance within the individual. I'm particularly delighted that this event is happening in a month when we have celebrated the first International Day of Yoga, just a few days ago, on the 21st of June. This makes Apollo and Saraswati connected to something which is very global and has touched the entire planet. I think many of you would know that we proposed, or India proposed, in September 2014, holding an International Day of Yoga. The idea of this Day of Yoga was to propagate the idea of yoga across the world so that it touches as many people as possible on the planet. In December last year, 177 countries co-sponsored this resolution. As Ambassador Bhandari said, this was beyond religion. 47 of these countries belong to the Islamic faith, many to the Christian faith, but yoga was something that was beyond religion. It belonged to all faiths, to all mankind. What we had on the 21st of June was heartwarming. We had 191 of the 193 countries in the world celebrating yoga in more than 250 cities. And I'm delighted to tell you that Poland is one of the countries that has adopted yoga with so much passion. We had 21 cities, including, of course, Opole and Warsaw, where we had public events. More than 8,000 people showed up. And, you know, we know that there are more than 800 centers teaching yoga. So Poland has adopted yoga as its own, as something that is a beautiful form of improving the individual, bringing him closer, bringing him and her closer to the ultimate. And what really delights us more than anything else is that at Apollo and at Saraswati, we have gone much deeper than this, the International Day of Yoga, which was to introduce yoga. But here, the yoga conference predates our decision to have the International Day of Yoga. This is when it is being studied with so much seriousness, and we are very, very confident that this will be ground zero of the yoga movement, This is where yoga will be studied, where the message of yoga will be propagated, and a message that yoga is not just an ancient technique, but it is something which can be verified by modern science, which brings huge benefits to the individual. So thank you so much for having me here. I'm delighted to be here, and I wish this conference all success. Thank you.